The project looks into whether you can use something like a smartphone and a wearable device, the kind of things people use to monitor fitness and activity, whether these things can tell you something about someone's clinical condition. And we're looking at three different disorders: depression, multiple sclerosis, and epilepsy.
People with CNS or brain diseases manifest symptoms that can be detected by technology. For example, there are changes in behavior, there are changes in how they sleep, there are changes in how they move, there are changes in how they socially interact, and these signals are well suited to being detected by technology. Overall, it's going to reduce costs. You know, it's an age-old saying that prevention is better than cure. Now, if you could actually predict and preempt a relapse, we know that we have potentially avoided a hospitalization, we have avoided expensive treatment, and these are the kind of savings that we will have to demonstrate.
The capacity for these sorts of devices to actually give you information which is informative for clinical practice and tells you something more objective about the person's current state is potentially huge. At the end of 5 years, we'll really have a much better idea about whether these technologies give information which is clinically useful and informative.